I had decided to go to New York after I went through a breakup. We had been going off and on for 4 years, and I had invested so much of my time and my energy and what I thought was going to be the rest of my life. And when that didn't happen in the summer, I finally just made this decision that I was like, I need to go to New York. And so I had bought tickets to go to New York, and then I met Tony. Tony and I actually met through a dating app. So the dating app is from our faith called Mutual.
Actually, I could even go further into that. Our original dating app, 2 years prior to us meeting, there was a dating app called LDS Singles. And so I had seen this beautiful gal, you know, I messaged her, I winked at her, I hinted at her. I remember trying all the little platforms of trying to get her attention. And no response.
I had no luck with dating. I had been in and out of relationships, but nothing just solidified.
2 years later, I'm hunting again, and I get back on this new dating app called Mutual. Like the second day I get into the app, I said, I know this girl. Like, this is the girl who dogged me out last time, who didn't give me no time of day.
He didn't have much info on there, and he had one picture on there where he had two girls that were in the picture, and they looked like him. I was like, he didn't mention that he had kids. Finally, at the end of the day, I finally just swiped right because I was like, he's a good looking guy, why not?
People do look at the photos and they see the surface, then they dive in, and whether if I have four kids or if it's just not clicking. Online dating didn't work for me. But with Rachel, I knew it was her that I wanted to talk to from even 2 years ago. Even 2 years prior, I wanted to talk to her, and she didn't talk to me then, and I still wanted to talk to her.
So when we first started talking, Tony and I, we exchanged very basic surface-level conversation questions, is what I like to call it. And then there was one question that he asked in which I responded to. And then immediately after I responded, he sent this follow-up answer, something like, I'm gonna throw caution to the wind, but I always look forward to receiving messages from this app because I hope it's from you. And I looked at it and I was like, too soon, way too forward. I'm not gonna respond, I'm done.
I just didn't wanna play the silly back and forth games. I wouldn't say I was aggressive, but I would say I was forward because I absolutely wanted a shot at dating her, 100%.
I went to work the next day. And my colleagues had asked me about my experience, you know, going back and forth on this dating app and some of the messages that I got. And so I told them, this guy who I've been talking with a little bit, he came out with this super forward text, and I just, it's too much. Like, I'm not ready. I'm not gonna respond. They said, Rach, you really need to just get your act together. He's a really sweet guy. He seems like he's very genuine. And so I ended up responding. And from there, I just really was attracted to his witty personality. Just, he was so good with words. He was so good with conversation. There was a lot of banter back and forth. And I had told him, hey, you know, I'm gonna be going to New York for the next week. And he said, well, when you get back, I really wanna go out on a date with you.
The whole reason why she was even in New York was she was looking for an apartment, looking for a new job, looking to start a new, starting to move out of San Diego and start a new life.
And I was having this conflict of interests, like, do I follow my career because I've been so successful at it and that's the only thing that's really working out in my life right now? While I was saying, you know, I wanted to settle down, the idea scared me a little bit because I had never been with somebody who was like, you are what I want. You are everything I've ever envisioned.
You know, how about I just pick you up at the airport? And I give you a ride home, you know, you don't have to take an Uber, and then we can meet. She thought that was a little forward. I know she thought that was weird because we hadn't even met yet and I wanted to pick her up at the airport. But it didn't work out. I ended up having work. So I said, how about we just meet the day before our date? Let's go on a pre-date.
I get home from work, so I'm trying to figure out what my outfit's going to be like. And I'm looking in my closet and I just had this feeling, you need to look nice. And he gives me a call at 6:15 because he's supposed to pick me up at 6:30 from my house. And he says, hey, I'm a little bit early, so just take your time, but I'm just gonna be outside your house, you know, when you're ready. And so I ran to the window and I peeked open the blinds and I see this super nice white Mercedes and this guy step out. He's tall, dark, and handsome, and he's wearing a three-piece suit.
So I had this whole elaborate plan planned out. I got a buddy of mine who lives kind of near her, right? I call him up and I'm like, Jay, I need you to do me a favor. I'm gonna go eat at this sushi restaurant at this time. Why don't you go an hour before me, already eat your meal with your wife, And as you're walking out, I'll be casually walking in and we can be like, hey, what's up? And then we'll do the whole thing where we had no idea we were gonna be there. And then you talk me up.
I immediately panicked. I let go of the blind and I turned at my roommate and I was like, I can't go. I can't do this. Like, I'm really nervous. He's so cute. Oh my gosh.
I'm telling you, I pulled all the stops out to make sure Rachel was gonna know that I was the guy she needed to be with.
I grabbed the door handle and I said, okay, like, have confidence. You can do this.
I knew what she looked like. I knew she looked beautiful. I knew she was gonna come out stunning. She killed it. She looked gorgeous.
He and I met and he opened my door and the funniest story is when I got in the passenger side of the car, I was like this. And he was looking at me like, is everything okay? And I was like, I've never done this before. I don't know what to do. Like, this is my first online date and I'm really nervous. So just give me a few minutes. And he said, okay. I'm surprised he didn't turn around and say, you can leave now. But we had such a great time. We had sushi and had a great dinner.
Jason, he walks by, taps me on the shoulder. And he's like, hey, Tony, what's up? What a surprise. Plan worked exactly as I said it was going to work. Jason nailed it. He nailed it.
So Tony and I, after our first date, pretty much spent every single day together. We couldn't get enough of one another. We loved spending time with one another. We felt comfortable. And so I think it was into maybe the second week of us dating, he had said, you know what? Can you take days off of work? I said, sure. And he said, all right, I'm gonna take you away in a secret staycation and we're gonna just go away.
I had planned an elaborate 5 days. And the reason why it was 6 days is because I left the sixth day for her to plan.
We stayed in this adorable, like, cottage.
We ended up doing this concert. We were doing fine dining. We were doing a hike with the rope climb.
We went horseback riding and hiking and just did so many amazing activities that really brought us together. There was no distraction, and it was just him and I giving it an honest shot.
Okay.
We just had the best stay at the best B&B.
I was gonna say that.
I was willing to give her the world. I mean, I was willing to do anything to spend time with her. I think that was overwhelming for her.
He planned an itinerary. He involved my coworker, my roommate, and he made sure that I had the appropriate outfits and the shoes. That's when I realized, wow, this man really cares so much about me. I've never had that before. It was always me investing all of myself into the relationship. One time we were just sitting and, you know, I was holding him and I remember just getting tears like in my eyes, and I started sniffling and he goes, are you getting sick? And I said, no, you know, and I was trying to hide it. But I think at that moment I was like, wow, this could be my forever. And this is what I've always wanted.
I knew I wanted to marry Rachel. I had already purchased a ring in the beginning of December and we had met in October. Proposing to Rachel kind of started, it didn't start on January 1st. It didn't just start, hey, this is the day I'm gonna propose to her. There were very integral dates involved. There was Thanksgiving, there was December 12th, I believe. There was a day around Christmas, and then there was New Year's Eve. And these days are all important because that was our slow introduction to the kids. You have to understand, it's 8-10 years of wanting and yearning for the kids and I to have Rachel. I wanted it to be a family. And New Year's Eve was that moment where 12/01, 2018, I had a wife and a mother for my kid. I had a family.
We stayed up late with the kids and we did a toast for when the ball dropped, and he said, you know what, I'm gonna take you out on a really nice date on Monday. And so I said, okay, and that's not out of the norm for him, so I wasn't expecting anything.
A whole month goes by of me planning, and I got this videographer, a photographer, a string of roses, of lights, a big rose-shaped thing. I was thinking candlelight dinner on top of the roof.
So I got ready and we drove together, and he said, you know what, we're still a little bit early for dinner reservations, so I'm gonna show you around one of the properties that my company manages. I'm gonna show you around. So we get into this elevator and he keys the elevator and it takes us up to the very, very, very top. The doors open and there are rose petals everywhere, candles everywhere, and there's a chalkboard that says San Diego Sky.
She was singing this song to me called Oklahoma Sky. So I kind of set up a situation where it was called the San Diego Sky.
there was a song at one of our dates that I sang in the car, and he said, oh, you have to record that for me. Well, I secretly recorded it and I sent it to him while we were dating. Tony grabs my hand, he said, let's dance. And I said, okay. So we start dancing and the music stops. And I'm like, what's going on? And then they plug in the music again and it's me singing the song that I sang to him in a video.
How long has it taken me to find you? 500 years, 500,000 miles. It don't matter now. Love's always on time. Meet me underneath the Oklahoma sky.
And so then he got down on one knee after the song finished, and then he proposed. He said things like, you make me a better man, as he's, you know, got tears coming down his face. And he's like, I don't want to live another day without you. I don't want to start this year without, you know, another day with you. And so then we got engaged.
All our sorrows swept away forever. Each and every tear washed out to sea. There ain't no goodbyes with your hand in mine. Meet me underneath the Oklahoma sky. I love you.
I can't be the man that I want to be without Rachel. That's just the honest to God truth. I can't be the man that I'm meant to be without Rachel.
Since the very first time we started dating, I just felt so comfortable with him, and he made me a better person. It sounds so cliche, and I hated when people said that. I hated when people said, I'm marrying my best friend, but it couldn't be, you know, more true. He makes me so happy. I'm so in love with him, and I cannot wait to continue our lives together.
Rachel has a way of making me feel like the man of her dreams, and I couldn't ask for anything better.